Hello everybody, this is the Crew 2.0 feedback video, which is currently being tested in Sandbox. So keep in mind, everything is subject to change and it might be dependent on our feedback. Let's get started. First, let's take a look on the new Crew interface, how it looks like. Here you can see already some good ideas, like for example special skill Sixth Sense, which is going to be available for everybody. Every crew will have it automatically, so if you recruit new crew, you will have Sixth Sense with that. Another good idea is a crew specialization. As you can see, you can assign one crew to three different tanks, which is really nice. The price for that is 750 gold, which is a fair price, as I can say, it's okay for me. Another interesting idea is crew instructors. As you can see here, it is interesting idea behind the special crew conversion, but I will talk about it later. Let's take a look on the crew skills. Here is my best crew converted. So let's take a look on my current crew. As you can see, there are quite few perks trained to 100%, like camouflage or firefighting. Repairs are almost fully trained, it is 377%. Let's take a look on the crew 2.0. As you can see, I wasn't able to achieve same kind of results because there is not enough points, which is really disappointing. If you take a closer look on these little figures, you can see that some points are coming from instructors as instructor effect points. So if I am not counting with the instructor points, I wasn't able to achieve fully trained perks in a lot of cases. This crew was a normal crew without zero perk skill. They didn't receive any instructors after conversion. I had to assign instructors to them. So without them, they would probably suffer even more from conversion. Once I learned that in crew 2.0, I am unable to have some perks trained to 100%, I have decided that I'm going to do some additional testing and, for example, focus just for the aim circle on the move. So to create the same conditions, let's have a look on my current crew before conversion. Current crew is using this setup: the Brothers in Arms, Snapshot, Smooth Ride and the driving skills, which are going to be same on the test server. Take a look here. The coherence is equivalent to Brothers in Arms, Snapshot trained to 100%, which is 10 of 10 points, the off-road driving trained to 100%, clutch braking, smooth ride. So same conditions, same setup on the tank. Take a look on the setup on the tank, and here are the results of the M circle in full speed in IS4. The picture which you are looking on is the crew 1.0, and the second picture is crew 2.0. So as you can see, the crew 2.0 have bigger M circle on the move. I believe that this is something which will not make people very happy, especially on the killer crews like this. They might have invested a lot of money, a lot of gold, free experience, time, whatever, into this, and the M circle is just bigger. That is not very good, and the expertise points, which you can see here, does not compensate enough for these losses which we have seen already. Let me show you what I mean. Here is the direct comparison of the crew 1.0 and 2.0. As you can see, the expertise points boosted some stuff on this picture, on this second picture, like DPM, aiming time, but it's not too much. However, there are still some important things like aim circle on the move, which I believe is really important. Repairs are really important. Firefighting might be important on some tanks which are burning, so this is simply not enough. So wargaming, if you're listening, you are definitely going to need more points, more skill points, which will allow us to reach similar results as our previous crews, satisfying comparable results, and then we can experiment with the other stuff. Another thing which I noticed after conversion was the changed view range and camouflage values. While view range went up with the 0 point assigned to the view range skills, and camouflage went down with the 10 points assigned into the concealment skills, which I don't see as a good thing for the maps like Mountain Pass. Okay, now let's take a look on the dynamically changing skills in the battle, which wargaming calling situational skills, which I believe this is the most stupid idea of the crew 2.0, and I will explain why. Let's think about it. In the battle, I wasn't really paying attention to them because they clicked in the specific situations, and I didn't care about at all. When I'm really starting to taking care about those situational skills are the situations when enemy have that skills, and you will be never able to know which skills are going to click on the enemy tank. Like for example, you are playing a medium and you need to flank TD, and suddenly his skill is clicked, which will allow him to move faster, turn faster, and basically you can die because of that. Also the situations, you are one shot and you will not know if enemy can have the skill, and he will reload faster and you will die because of that. So prediction will become harder just like that, and it is not a good thing because it is only adding to randomness, which is already in the bad state in this game, and that's not good. Similar situation is with the talents. They are all situational, which means they are dynamically changing skills in the battle. You can only unlock them by meeting certain conditions, which is reaching 30 points, which also means that you will have to sacrifice something else which you might have or want on the tank, and that is not good. I would prefer rather to have more points, more skill points to spend in this pool, so we can experiment a bit more with the builds. Okay, moving on. I would like to also point out some good things in this pool, as some reward skills and perks, which you can see here. For example, Eyes Open, which provides some flexibility in the view range. The rationing is also nice, which decreasing cooldown of the consumables. Paint Result is nice, which decreasing chance of injury. Pedal to the Metal, that is also really good idea, which can be built with the equipment. Basically you can increase speed of your vehicle forward and backward with that. Anything else which is situational I didn't really like, except Intuition, that was situational even before. It just clicked sometimes, and this can stay. I like that. Okay, next topic, instructors. Let's have a take a look on them. Instructors are good idea behind the special crew conversion, but this idea is not executed very well or needs some tweaking. Definitely let me show you what I mean. If you decided to dismiss instructor from the crew, the penalty is going to be 7 days of waiting time if you want it for free, or 200 gold if you want him available right away. Let's say you have decided to dismiss instructor from the crew and replace him with another one. Here is how it looks like. For example, we will pick this one. Once you select a specification, you cannot really pick these skills, which you can see here. Everything is going to be randomly offered to you, which is really defeating purpose of the build. Once you select it, you cannot reroll it, and that's not really good thing. So please, Wargaming, this should be somehow fixed. Allow us to pick skills not randomly, but what we want, so we can build what we want. Another thing which I would like to point out is that many of us have crews for every single tank which is kept in garage, and after a conversion the best crews most likely are going to be assigned to these three slots that will probably leave a lot of crews unused. Maybe good idea for those unused crews will be convert them to XP and assign them to the best crew. That's just a suggestion. I don't really know what is going to happen with the unused crews, but there will be probably a lot of them. For now, I just hope that Wargaming is going to find a solution for this. We will see later on. The last thing before I wrap this up, I want to talk about in-game items conversion, as you can see here, which will hopefully never happen, or at least that is what I wish for. Here you can see some directives which are going to be converted, some directives are not going to be converted. What that really means is that they are cutting us out of options. I have already mentioned previously in the video on converted crew on IS4. With the same setup, the aim circle size on the move has become bigger. Hopefully that will be fixed, but what if we take into consideration tanks which have already bad gun handling, like you can see on this picture, the Cromwell B on the move. The circle size is really big. This is a crew 2.0. Build is made with the bounty equipment, and let's compare it with the crew 1.0. As you can see here, the circle is smaller and the build was made without bounty equipment, just the normal equipment. And just like that, with old gearbox integrity removed, we lost the option to mitigate this big circle size, and that's not really good. That's not really what people would wish for. So Wargaming, hopefully you will keep this in the game. Okay, let's summarize this video. Overall, I can see crew 2.0 as a cool concept, but it needs a lot of tweakings. I can imagine that this will be pushed through in some update in the future. but I really hope that Wargaming is going to listen our feedback. Things like crew will become worse after conversion and have not enough skill points to assign to experiment with the builds. Builds are not really acceptable, along with the randomly generated instructors. But there are also good stuff which I have mentioned already in the video. I hope this video is going to be informative for Wargaming, and I hope that rest of you liked it. So see you next time. Bye.